here to episode 81 of Tennessee Backyard Wrestling. This is good old JR Josh Ross, along with some of my broadcast colleagues,
Troy Scott
and Roger Cross.
How are y'all doing tonight?
And it looks like we're kicking things off
with Joshua Allen.
Right. Here comes the TBW General Manager, Joshua Allen.
Making his way to the ringside area. Got some big news regarding the result of Stars and Stripes. Let's hear what the big dog has got to say. Music, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to episode 81 of Tennessee Backyard Wrestling. Now, Scars and Stripes was the best event of all time. Great action. The Nature Boy is still on top of the mountain, thanks to Matthew Joseph, after that most despicable display of officiating a spine bustery ever seen in my life. And little Mike is still Mr. Bloodsport, defeating his old rival like Lewis. And Atomic Titan is now Mr. Goat in the Vault. Goat in the Vault. And ladies and gentlemen, rudely interrupted, might I add.
That sounds like the music of Atomic Titan.
Yes, indeed it is, there across. It is Atomic Freaking Titan, Mr. Gold in the Vault, who won the Gold in the Vault ladder match to get that contract.
Let's not forget what happened at Scars and Stripes. He did win that contract on Gold in the Vault, but the general manager had Redneck Mayhem attack Atomic Titan.
Again?
You know why I'm out here. You know exactly why I'm out here. You seen what happened at Scars and Stripes?
Yeah.
You put a fucking redneck fat ass on me. I wanted you to present me the fucking gold in the vault and see what your ass did. You were watching him out here putting me through a fucking table three fucking times and you couldn't even manage to stop it. Don't put your fucking hand on me, big dog.
You know that music, Glad
is.
He's a
recording artist, Austin Wise.
Well, we've seen him as the guest host for Scars and Stripes. I guess he's back tonight to restore a little bit of order and a little bit of sanity here. Because Josh Rowland and Atomic Titan is about to beat the crap out of each other.
Well, it looks like he did such a great job at Scars and Stripes, so now here he is on episode 81.
Oh, yes, he is. Multiple music recording artist on Spotify and other musical platforms, Mr. Austin Wise.
I'm excited to see what he's got to say. And you know I know that's a bunch
of snow. Guys, come on. Okay, wait, who the hell is this guy?
So, hey, Titan, first off, Austin Wise, nice to meet you. I was here at the Scars and Stripes. And
you just met the greatest TBW wrestler ever.
Actually, I'm really good friends with Gage, but no big deal. Look, I actually like your stuff, dude. As someone who really loves themselves, I can appreciate what you bring to the table, okay?
All right, I really appreciate that.
Look, and I'm not hearing no ill will toward either one of you. I just can't let my dog get attacked like what you were just doing to him, man.
You know what, in the shades of my mentor, it is good, brother, to have you in here.
Look, I am blessed to be back. Look, guys, I saw the, you know, the tittle-tattle and everything, and like, Big Dog came back here to make some announcements, and I couldn't, like, I was in the back, I heard things going on, I was waiting for my cue, all this happened, and then I don't know why I had to come out here to just make sure that we get to the point of what we have going on here tonight. We've got a big announcement outside of all the other festivities that's going on. Ain't that right, Big Dog?
Right. That is right indeed, brother. And you need to stop interrupting me. Stop. For fuck's sake.
Hey, look, he has a point of why he's upset. I get it. Look, he got man. Hey, that's guys. Look, listen to me. I get. Hey, look, if there's anyone on your side right now, it's me.
All right.
I saw what happened with I saw what happened with the dog, okay? I saw what happened with Redneck Mayhem. We don't need to happen again, and you let that happen. But that's why I'm here. I want to
let it happen? I can't control what he does. He is nuts.
He is, but you're still the boss, man. Look, we'll talk about it in the back over a drink or two, big guy. How about that? Well, I see, look.
Whatever, but first off, take your dorky ass glasses, put them somewhere else. This is wrestling, not America's Most Talent or America's...
Hey, you shut up. At least you don't have a cowboy hat.
Guys! Hey, look, hey, guys. First off,
I was just having your side there.
Thank
like you.
You
said, you had mine.
I've got everyone's side here.
What is that garbage? Let me see that garbage. What is that garbage?
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
What
whoa.
Is that? Wrestle performance my
oh,
ass.
Shut up.
Just get to the point.
You ain't got no performance.
But look, we got, look, I came out here to make sure that the main announcement that you have involving yours truly gets announced. So
you talked about to the back about that. You do that.
You're right. Look, I want to make sure that there's peace amongst you guys. I see this every week, and I'm like kind of want to make sure there's some peace here. And I love that I'm brought back here. At Scars and Stripes, I had an amazing time. I love being the host. I love being a part of this great company. I see the potential and the growth that can happen here. And I want to be involved with you, Big Dog, to make
all
right, it happen.
All right.
That's why over the weekend, we sat down, we talked, we worked it out, and I, Austin Wise, have agreed to exclusively work here at TBW as your new big-time host for the evening. And guess what? Tonight is the debut of the brand new TBW talk show, The Wise Times. Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Titan. And look, we have a lot to get started with tonight. And I have the Backyard Wrestling Heavyweight Champion in my ring later on. That's right. On the very first episode of The Wise Times, I will have in this ring the world's heavyweight champion, the Nature Boy, Gage Flair. So I need my time with the Nate.
We definitely need some answers on what's going on with Nature Boy and his buddy, Matthew Joseph.
That's very true.
And I can't wait to cash in on Gage Flair and be the next TBW
do
champion.
Do you think people want to see your ass gloating about with that title again? It's history. We know what happens. I didn't have to use people like you to get where I was. I did it by myself with the help of these people watching all over the freaking world. I'd have to use men. I'd have to use factions. So what do you got? You didn't earn a damn thing in this show.
Tell you what I got.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a sign of disrespect. Atomic Titan slapping the hell out of the general manager.
And once again, his big fat ass ego comes into fruition again. God dang it. Come on. What the hell was that? Cut that music. Cut that music. Cut that music. Hey, jackass! Before you leave, you're in a mess tonight, you selfish son of a bitch! You don't slap me! I can buy your ass from here to hell is high water! You're booked in a mess tonight, like it or not! If you don't want to do it, hit the fucking road!
I love it! I love it! Because I'm the best!
This is the story of a bitter end and a new beginning. The story of self-doubt and triumph. This is my story, the Lake Lewis story.
Nothing. nasty. That is probably somewhat of a travesty having me. Jimmy told the people you could pull.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen, after that great commercial break, and it is now time for the very first episode of the Wise Times, presented by Austin Wise and TBW Wrestling, respectively. It is a great day to be here, and I have a dynamite, a bombastic, nuclear first guest. After Scars and Stripes, the war he had with Ledger ends in questionable means. I've got questions as a TBW fan. So tonight, my very first guest here on the show is none other than the World Heavyweight Champion, the Nature Boy, Gabe Flair!
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, you know the music. And I'll say it once and I'll say it again. Boys, help me out here. The limousine ride, jet flying, get stealing, wheeling, dealing, son of a gun. The Nature Boy, Gage Flair.
No one has styled, no one has profiled such as this man right here.
I couldn't agree with you there, Cross.
I'll agree with you. The most flamboyant, the most rash, the most outspoken veteran of the backyard is making his way to the ringside, and let's get this Wise time underway.
I'm excited to see what Wise has to say for the next one. What do you think, Troy?
Me too. I believe. I can't wait to see if Matthew Joseph is going to answer.
Gentlemen, the Nature Boy, Gage Flair.
It's good to be on the Austin Wise time.
That's right. Woo. It is the limousine riding, yeah. Jet flying, woo. Kiss stealing, wheeling dealing, son of a gun. Woo. Look at
all the hard guys.
Hold these days, days down.
Woo. Yeah.
If it ain't the guy, my champ, take a seat. Woo. Let's talk, let's have a chat about what's been transpiring. Now look, if I have to give you a real quick compliment, you and Ledger went to war at Scars and Stripes. I've got to just give it up to you for that.
Absolutely. Ledger, he brings the absolute best out of the Nature Boy.
Woo! I can tell. You guys went to war, and that title is still around your waist, and I'm proud of you.
Woo!
For it. I'm happy to see that as a friend. So, like, you and Ledger are done right now, right?
Yes. That was my final battle with Ledger. Done. History. It's over.
I tell you what, champ, it was a tough match. How do you feel coming out of that match?
I couldn't feel any better. I feel like I'm on top of the world.
Yeah.
Woo!
That's what I like to hear, champ.
I feel good. I feel great.
Now, you won. Okay, I hate to cut you off, champ. I hate to cut you off. But you won. But even I, as a fan of yours, was shocked to see Matthew Joseph interfere with the way that he did. Why? What? Like, the question is, like, I know you can't speak for Matthew Joseph, but why? Did you guys work something out? Was there an agreement? What have we, the audience, missed?
Matthew Joseph, listen closely.
Okay.
Matthew Joseph was watching his friend's back. He's been in the backyard wrestling world as long as I have been. He was just watching out for me. And he knew if Ledger was to win the TBW World Championship belt, then TBW would have been done, would have been over with. Woo!
You say that.
So Matthew Joseph knew. He knew that. And that's why Matthew Joseph is not here tonight.
Oh, he's not.
Matthew Joseph isn't here tonight because he's playing it smart. Matthew Joseph is playing it smart. He knew Ledger would be here tonight. Mm. So that's the very reason why Matthew Joseph did not come out here tonight. A matter of fact, I gave him a phone call. I said, brother, lay low. Mm. Lay low. Because Ledger is out for vengeance. That's what he's after.
That's a scary thing. And look, I get he was doing his thing, but I'm not satisfied with that answer. I need to talk to Matthew Joseph as soon as I possibly can. So I need you, whenever you get the chance, call him up and tell him that Austin Wise has some questions that needs some answers.
Matthew Joseph will be the man to finally end Ledger That will be the man to end Ledger.
We'll see.
But Matthew Joseph, listen. Listen up. Listen to me closely. You know how me and you go way back, brother. You know Ledger in and out like I do. To end Ledger for good, it's going to take you.
Look, woo! Champ, and like, I get it. You know, I can hear what you're saying with him being on your side, protecting TBW. But like, that belt to me, and I can speak for everyone, the TBW audience all
around
the world.
Yes, sir.
I can speak for them when they say, look, that championship has honor and respect to it. And with what happened at Scarlet Stripes, how can you, look, up to this point in your reign, I've been a fan. But that was the first time I ever questioned your integrity.
And I'm a fan of yours. Why?
But my thing is,
you've got tunes like no other.
And I appreciate
woo!
That. And I know that you have moves woo! In this ring like no other. So why do you feel as if that you had to stoop to the point of using Matthew Joseph to keep the belt around your waist? You don't need that. You're the champion. You've earned it all the way up to this point. Why did that need to happen to defeat Ledger? Couldn't you take him?
It all boils down to this. I'm the dirtiest player in the game. Woo! That's what it boils down to. I'm the dirtiest player in the game. I just wanted to make things interesting. That's what I wanted.
Well, now you've made things interesting for sure, because now we have so much going on. And I don't, like, and not in the midst of all this, what are your plans? How are you going to go forward from this event? From the best match of your career, how do you go forward as the champion? How can you keep going forward now that you still have the belt at the end of the day? So what is next for you?
I've faced them all. There is in TBW, from Lake Lewis, Cruz Lewis, Joshua Allen, Atomic Titan, Ledger, Fat Asian.
That's a resume. That's a
Tennessee
resume.
Rattlesnake.
That's a resume.
The list goes on and on and on. But there's one man I have yet to face off in a squared circle. And matter of fact, I seen him backstage earlier tonight. I want him out here right now.
Well,
and that's Little Mike.
What?
Holy crap, here comes Little Mike, the Bloodsport champion.
Yes, Bloodsport champion about to come back to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it. The next boy said there's one man that he has not one-on-one faced off with in the ring, and it's the Bloodsport champion himself, Little Mike.
I couldn't agree anymore there, gentlemen. This is a technical test for the Nature Boy. Will we see these two lock horns?
Now here he is, ladies and gentlemen.
Little Mike, what is he going to come out here and say? I'm sure it's going to be something about what Gage Flair just had to say.
Let's remember, tension has been growing between these two men over the past year, ever since Gage Flair cheated him out of his title.
And yes, he did, all because of the C4 with Alexander and Titan back then. Let's see what Mike has to say. Whoa!
As always, you're nothing.
How about you shut up?
As always, you're nothing but a clumsy. You're nothing but clumsy, son of a bitch. That's all you are.
Gentlemen. First off, welcome.
You better watch who you're stepping in front of, buddy.
I don't give a fuck.
Woo!
Guys, gentlemen.
You play mate toy belt.
Mac toy? Oh, really? More prestigious than death belts?
Yeah.
Oh, really? It's a lot longer than you have. I'm the first guy to have a title over 200 days.
You gotta respect. And I am the real.
Boom.
I am the real world's heavyweight backyard wrestling champion. No, you're not. No, why? You ain't better than Maximus Roman in EBW. You ain't better than that. Our guys in MEW. You can't even speak. That's every time you come out here, you're blah, 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 blah. That's all you ever do.
It doesn't have matters. I have passion.
That's all you ever do.
Oh, shut up. You know, you talk about all those lists of guys you beat. There's one guy I did beat. You did it. Lake Lewis. Because that match was in a draw.
Lake Lewis laid down for you. That's what he did.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Bullshit, because he was up 2-1.
I'm everything. You're up 3-1 in your Army match, and you blew it.
Guys.
Like I said, shut up, fat boy. Go home and sleep with your mother tonight. Like I said, Lake Lewis laid down for you.
No, he didn't.
I know how tight you two are.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Like as high as you and Matthew.
Oh, you won't go there?
Yeah.
Guys, let's not. We need some peace and order here on my show. This is still my time, okay?
Woo!
Y'all don't come out here acting like children on my time, okay? Look, you guys have some animosity. You guys have some heat.
Yeah.
I get it. Summer Bash is around the corner, is it not?
I know where his anger comes from. You know where it comes from? Because this time last year, the company kept calling you and calling you and calling you. And so I said, you know what? I'm going to have two of my henchmen go over to his place and knock him out. And you was on your last leg because the company said, this is your last time to come. And I made sure you was on your way. You was on your way. Yes, he was on his way. But my two henchmen at the time, Titan and Alexander, took you out.
Yeah, you know, I did miss some time.
Woo!
But let me tell you something. I was dealing with some personal demons with mine, right? I struggled. I saw my grandpa health get worse, all right? You don't know what he's been through. He had cancer twice. He went neuropathy. He had a heart attack. That heart attack made me motivated to come back into TVW, all right, to get my mind off things.
I'm glad your motivation's back, brother. That's why.
Woo!
That's why. Me and you has gotta happen soon.
Yeah, Summer Bash for you and me for the TVW heavyweight title and the Bloodsport title.
Yeah, you know what? It's on, it's on. Cause I've been wanting this.
Yeah.
I wanna do something Lake Lewis couldn't do, and that's beat you.
Wait a minute, he beat me twice, you idiot. I don't know where you get your facts at, but you need to correct it.
You know
what? Oh, yeah, because he went to Macon County High School.
He didn't beat you the last time, and that's what I'm going to do, is beat you, and that's something he didn't do the third try.
Baby likes to rock it like a buggy buggy choo-choo train.
Cut the music! Cut it! Cut it! Cut it! What in the Sam hell is going on here?
I was trying to have a show, and then these guys, they started doing this. They started yelling.
Both of you men are the most top champions in this company.
Woo!
I don't want no bitching. I don't want no yelling. Mike, I'm glad you're back, man. And I'm going to tell you one thing. You are the longest champion in this damn promotion, and you have raised the bar. But you, I am disrespected of you. You had to hire a goddamn referee to do your damn work.
You want to talk about disappointment? You're nothing but a disappointment.
Throw around this damn car, don't you? You know what? Summer Bash, that match is going to happen.
Yeah.
And Matthew Joseph's not going to ref that
match. Yeah. What?
Joseph ain't refing the match.
Are you for real? You kidding me?
Did I just stutter? Joseph is banned from the arena. He's not going to ref your damn match. Somebody else is going to ref it. So you can't pull what you did at Scars and Stripes. But tonight, for tonight, I'll take your damn Rolex off, your 50-cent Rolex, your $12 suit. By the way, tonight, you guys might hate me for this, but what the hell? You guys need to settle your differences one way or another. So tonight, in the main event, for the first time ever, y'all two will be joining forces in a tag team match.
I'm ready for anything. You understand, fat boy?
Woo!
God almighty, like a house of fire, Gage Fire is railing on little Mike.
No, little Mike's on top of him.
Both of these men are going at it inside the square circle.
Why is, if I was you, I'd get back. I'd hit yourself there, man.
Whoa!
Good grief!
It's
We just got this small preview of what's going to happen at Summer Bash.
We got tagged tonight.
Sadly.
Woo! Woo! Whoa! Whoa!
Are you sick of the same old barbecue crap? Well, then now, coming very soon, I present to you good old J.R. Josh Ross's bone-sucking sweet baby sauce coming up anywhere. Get your sauce today.
I definitely gotta get some of that for my ribs, steak, and hot dogs.
Ladies and gentlemen, for opening contest, it's a battle of paint, Ledger and Clay, first time ever.
It's gonna be sweet. Baby,
maybe
knocking, locking
sucks.
That's what's
gonna
be.
Is that what it is there, Josh Ross?
Who's gonna walk out the winner? Find out next. And ladies and gentlemen, you hear the music of the man known as Ledger.
Well, we know he's out here tonight for vengeance. That's exactly what he's out here for tonight.
He wants Matthew Joseph. I don't think Joseph might not be here, or is he here? We don't know. We haven't heard from him.
Well, Gage Flair stated that Matthew Joseph is not here in the middle of the night. But here comes Ledger. He looks mean. He looks vicious. He looks prepared.
He looks pissed off to me because Joseph isn't here and he can't kick his ass.
I can't wait to see what he's about to say. Let's listen in.
Last time I was here, as you all know, I was so close to ending Gage Flair. I was one step away from ending the fraud known as the Nature Boy Gage Flair. I was so close from making TBW a much better place for everyone. Not just for me, but for everyone. But as you all seen, he had to have somebody save him from me, because he knows exactly where I was taking the company. Now, Matthew Joseph. You're a coward, and you will pay deeply for your foolishness. Why are you not here tonight, huh? Huh?
And there's the music of the insane White Jacket Freak himself.
Yeah, White Jacket indeed, the Cross. Get this freaking idiot in a straight jacket. And wait, there's Clay, and he's got a referee with him.
Looks like he might be ready for this matchup.
He's come prepared. He's got our official. Wait, Clay's running like a house of fire. He's got that skateboard. Look at him.
Hey, Messy Master!
Sling Blade!
What a Sling Blade delivered there by Ledger! This match is underway!
After with a Sling Blade, Ledger is on now fixing to kick the crap out of Clay!
No, he's punching away at Clay!
That's how you start a match, ladies and gentlemen. That's how you start a match. And as you can see, we have Ledger with a headlock on Andrew Clay.
And I believe the bell has already been rung. Referee rung the bell. Ledger and Clay, first time ever. And now,
he sends him off, comes back.
Clothesline by Clay.
And what a big, vicious clothesline delivered by Clay. Those arms are like tree trunks.
He's like another clothesline.
Like a big tree running at you with a big arm with a clothesline. No, Ledger's in the corner.
Ledger's in the corner.
Here comes Clay. Oh, Clay misses.
Ledger was able to dodge out of the way there. Now Ledger is on the upper hand.
Ledger on the offense, punching away at Clay. It's a battle of the paints, a battle of the freaks, more like it.
Oh, what a clothesline right there,
wow,
by Ledger.
What a vicious clothesline delivered by Ledger.
2-0.
Clay kicks out of that pinfall predicament, fans.
That was a very beautiful executed clothesline, like I said, delivered by Ledger.
Indeed. And now Clay has got a choke applied around the throat of Andrew Clay.
Will Andrew Clay tap here? Will he tap?
I don't think he's going to tap, Cross. He's insane. Insane as they come.
Well, looks like Andrew Clay's back on his feet, but Ledger still viciously has that lock hold in.
Both of these men are insane, I might add.
Oh! What a backflip!
Backflip, look out! Oh, what a knee to the chest!
That knee goes straight to the chest of that giant Andrew Clay, and down he goes.
Oh, no! Looks like Ledger is stomping away every body part you can think of. Arms, legs, ankles.
And it's a very smart tactic. Ledger attacks every body part, just like you said, Ross. A very smart tactic.
Indeed. Word down the big man, because Clay has got...
Oh!
Standing moonsault. 1, 2, no! Like I said... Clay has got the strength, but Ledger's got the speed.
And the agility.
And the agility, yes, sir. And now, right now, Ledger is pounding away on Clay.
And pushing him off of him. What's he going to do? Enziguri.
Enziguri into the corner.
What an Enziguri executed there by Ledger.
Pinfall. 1, 2, no.
Only a two count. Only a two.
Only a two count there. Clay kicks out.
That's right, Ross. He kicks out once again.
This match is interesting, to say the least, folks. For the first time ever here, look out. Oh.
You're going to watch out with those gigantic hands of Andrew Clay. And now Andrew Clay throws Ledger to the corner there.
And oh, what a forearm.
Forearm strike right there by Clay.
2-0, and Ledger kicks out.
Ledger kicks out of that forearm strike.
Only a two count delivered there by Andrew Clay.
What a performance Clay is showing against Ledger here.
These men are going at it. I will give them that.
Clay is demanding Ledger to get to his feet.
Let's go, Ledger.
Yes, he is.
Let's go,
Clay needs to capitalize. Don't wait around. Clay is walking over to Ledger.
Ledger's a dangerous man, Clay.
Both men are dangerous.
Don't let Ledger get any type of rest or he'll get the upper hand.
Indeed, indeed, they're Cross. Both of these men are very unorthodox, to say the least.
And Andrew Clay just throws Ledger across the ring there.
Ledger is in the corner, Clay in one corner. What's going to happen now, folks? Clay's walking over. Look out! Oh! A discus like kick back and forth.
Right. And wait a minute. It goes for a DDT, and there's a DDT executed by Ledger at the pinfall.
1, 2, 0.
Skull-cracking DDT by Ledger.
And Ledger's pounding away. And like I said, he aims at every body part.
Every body part that he can utilize. And look at a running, diving knee drop.
A vicious, vicious knee drop.
Knee right to the skull of Clay.
Once again, working on the head of Clay.
Working on
There's not much up there to begin with.
Well, you got that right, Cross. He is nuts. Wait a minute.
Wait, what's he doing?
It looks like Ledger is going to the top.
Ledger's going up. He's going up.
Clay, get to your feet, man.
Will Ledger be able to send off from the top?
I don't know, but Clay is in deep trouble right here, folks. Clay is back on his feet.
2.
What's he doing? He's going over to Ledger. Oh, wait a minute. Ledger's on his shoulders. Look out below. Fireman's carry net breaker by Andrew Clay.
What a beautiful fireman's carry delivered by Andrew Clay. That was very effective.
But the Samson-like strength of Clay is unbelievable.
And now both men are down and the ref is counting here.
Rev is counting both of these men down. They're down on the canvas. It could be a draw if they don't get up.
That's true. This could very well be a draw if either one of the two individuals doesn't get up.
Clay is back to his feet.
Clay is back to his feet.
Clay's back up. Clay is back up.
Ledger is, I guess, almost trying to get to his feet.
You cannot let Ledger capitalize. This is what he does. He rests in the turnbuckles.
Indeed. You cannot let Ledger get a breather. Stay on him. All head first from the turnbuckle.
And that sends Ledger a little dizzy headed there.
Come on, Clay. Get on him. Oh, what an elbow to the chest. And now what's Clay? Ooh, what a move right there by Clay. What a knee to the back of the spine.
And Clay looks like he's working on the back of Ledger.
He is definitely working on the back. Pinfall. Oh, and a two count.
Only a two. It was only a two there.
I thought he might have had after that.
This has been one hell of a match.
Back and forth action by both of these athletes, both of these big, both of these men.
Oh, he's going to go for dirty deeds, but Ledger gets out of the dirty deeds.
Oh, running knee strike to the chest.
He's doing everything he can to get this big man down.
Look out, look out, look out. Oh. Bulldog.
There's a running knee to the face of Andrew Clay into a bulldog.
One, two. Oh, kick out by Clay. Ledger has done everything in his. Oh, no. Don't do it. Don't do it. No, don't do it. Oh, my punt kick.
What a vicious punt kick. Lights out.
And it I think it is there.
What?
Cross one, two, and three. Lights out. Game over for Andrew Clay. What a matchup by both of these athletes, both of these competitors. I got to give it to Clay on this one, folks. What a performance for the first time ever meeting between these two. I don't think these men might, we might see these men again in the future.
Well, both of these men are both strange individuals. And all I got to say is Ledger keeps impressing me every time he steps in that ring.
Indeed, he's impressed me a lot. As well, Cross. Clay is down, might be out after that dangerous punt kick. Wait a minute, what the hell is this?
What's this freak doing?
Morpheus, you are obviously lost your damn mind.
Oh my god, what is he doing?
Oh, come on. Whatever this. Oh,
right to the.
Ledger's not taking no shit. He got him with a knee strike. Oh my god. Kick to the midsection.
What's he doing? He's giving him a Falcon's arrow.
Falcon arrow.
Beautifully executed.
Wait a minute. Kip up. Oh, he about lost his footing. No, he's not. He got it. No. Oh no. Not again. Not again. It's time for Punch City. Come on, right. You hear the crack of the skull of Morpheus.
I think the ambulance will be coming for Morpheus after that.
Come after Clay as well, for God's sake. This, I thought Clay was crazy, but Ledger is even more crazy. Tonight, Clay met his crazy match. Made in hell, so to speak.
What's he doing with that chair?
Oh, come on, don't use
Clay,
it.
Looks like he's not finished. He's not finished.
Let's listen to what Ledger has got to say.
Didn't have to be this way. I didn't want you, and I definitely didn't want you. Now, sorry for all the chaos, but I didn't just defeat one, but two, in one night, back to back. Now, Matthew Joseph, I hope you're listening. I really hope you're listening loud and clear, because take a look around. That would have been you, but you're a coward, and you always have been, ever since the beginning. You act like you're a hero. You're not a hero. You're just as phony as Gage Flair. want to play games? Well, you picked the wrong person to play games with. You see, this is my board, and you're about to play my game. You're not here tonight, obviously, but I will get my revenge. Yeah. I will lure you out one way or another. If you don't want to show on your own terms, then it's gonna be me forcing you out. And believe me, I've got just the trick to do it.
You heard it, ladies and gentlemen. Ledger said he's not going to stop until he gets Matthew Joseph inside of that squared circle. And what is it going to take? What is Ledger going to do to get Matthew Joseph to respond to him?
Well, I came by, you know, I couldn't find you anywhere else, so I came by here, I was wondering, you got anything for me tonight?
Anything for you? I don't know, everybody's coming to me, wanting stuff booked, everything, this and that, it's been chaotic.
Well, see, I'm the champ.
Ledger and stuff.
You know, I'm a defending champ.
I know you're a defending champ, and I appreciate
it. Well, see, I stopped by too, because earlier in the show, you said you had a match for me, but I'm not sure what that match is. I know you booked a tag match, but, so, who's their opponent? You never announced that.
Well, I'm glad both of you showed up, because I know both of you have had some tremendous things going on in the past. So tonight, you two are facing Fleur and Mike.
This guy's crazy.
Hey, no. Hear me out. I'm getting them to team up to get them to bury the hatchet so they can go to Summer Bash, and I'm trying to get this shit resolved between you two. This has got to stop. Everybody's at each other's throats. I want to run a clean show here. I cannot have people at each other's throats.
Well, all I got to say is...
He's delusional.
I'm not delusional.
No, you are. Because if you think they're going to bury a hatchet after what happened... I mean, you're
on the wise times. I know what happened. I was out there. I saw the tapes.
You're crazy. Well, anyways, all I gotta say is we've had beef in the past. Tonight you're my partner. Let's work together and...
That's what I'm talking about. Work together. Teamwork, boys.
No one asked you.
It's like the general manager just informed Titan and Asian that they'll be teaming up tonight against Gage, Flair, and Little Mike.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, for the first time ever, enemies are partners, Flair and Mike, champs, versus the Kyle Champion Fat Asian and Atomic Titan. This is going to be a slobber knocker, and buy my barbecue sauce.
Who's going to survive? Find out next.
And ladies and gentlemen, it is main event time here at TBW.
Looks like you're about to lose your voice, Rawls.
I believe I am there, Carl.
This is one hell of a main event that's coming up. We've got Asian Titan versus Flair and Mitchell.
Little Mike, you mean there, Cross? What is wrong with you?
But here is Atomic freaking Titan,
Mr. Gold in the Vault, who got his... Got the golden ball and scars and stripes.
Yeah, let's not forget that. He did win that match to be the recipient of the golden vote contract, which he can cash in at any time.
Keep that in mind. Engage for by the watcher, that little sneaky little bastard when he gets his hands on the title. I can't stand him, folks. I'm sorry. I know you might like
him. Yeah, you're best friends with him behind the screen.
What the hell are you talking about?
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure he's not.
You damn right, Scott.
I'm pretty sure he did cuss him out on a few episodes ago, but
I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. But right now, Here comes the party animal, the Fat Asian.
Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, the Continental TBW Champion, Fat Asian.
I feel bad for Asian, folks. He got a team with the most obnoxious jackass ever was, but he's manned up, swallowed his pride, and he's going to team with Titan Eye in this main event.
I'm ready to see what these guys have in store. And
coming out now is opponent number one, Little Mike, the Bloodsport champion.
Little Mike is one hard fighter. That's what he is.
Indeed, he is, Thar Cross, a technician in the squared circle. Longest reigning champion today, right now as we speak, holding the prestigious Bloodsport championship belt.
Absolutely, Ross. And Little Mike is going to bring his A game. He's going to bring everything that he's got in this matchup.
Indeed, Cross as well. Can Flair and Mike coexist, put their beef behind them, and settle the opposition tonight?
The referee is patting down Little Mike, checking if he has any weapons. Probably that dildo in his pocket.
How would you know what he had? Anyway, and there he is.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the limousine riding,
jet flying, he's stealing, wheeling, dealing, son of a gun.
The nature boy Gage Flair is making his way to the ring, sporting that red robe like he always does, styling and profiling.
No one has styled, no one has profiled quite like the nature boy.
Indeed, Cross, nobody has done it like the Nate.
I'm ready for this match.
I'm ready.
It's going to be all kinds of action.
But can these teams coexist? We know the history of Asian and Titan.
And Little Mike.
And Little Mike, all three of them as well, yes.
But here we're going to listen in.
The following contest is the main event of the evening. Introducing first in the right corner. First of all, from Party City, USA, a Fat Asian,
yes,
and his tag team partner from parts unknown, Mr. Go to the Vault, the best Atomic Titan. And in the left
corner. Why would he ever do this to me?
In the left corner, first of all, he is the reigning and defending Bloodsport champion of the world, Little Mike.
And a future world champion at Summer Bash.
And his tag team partner from El Paso, Texas. He is the reigning and defending TBW
Woo!
Nature Boy.
You in first, buddy.
Right. Referee is Austin Wise.
Well, a good clean match, gentlemen, all right? Make sure you do these good tags. Clean tags. Let's do it well, okay? Who's starting off? Who's starting
paper, scissors. Remember, Lewis has to go in.
You're in.
This is Big Mo.
All right.
Whatever.
All right, you ready?
I guess.
You ready?
Yeah.
Ring the bell.
How's that?
The main event is underway. Oh. Flair, Mike, Titan, and Asian.
But it looks like we got Little Mike and Asian in the ring first.
Yes, sir. We have Asian and Mike in the ring. Lock up.
Here they go, ladies and gentlemen, with a lockup, but Little Mike takes down Fat Asian down to the mat with that headlock.
Down to the mat goes Asian and Mike. And now, looks like
Asian's trying to get out of it somehow.
Little Mike is staying on him, and that's exactly what he needs to do here, folks. Stay on him, stay on him.
Indeed, stay on your opposition. He's trying to choke him out or make him pass out, whatever he's trying to do. And now Mike goes into some sort of leg lock.
Little Mike is going to lock in whatever he can at any given time.
And our guest official, Austin Wise, is trying to break the hold.
Oh, and what a vicious elbow delivered by Little Mike.
Now Adrian is coming back with some vicious right hands.
Right and left, right and left.
Stomping away at Little Mike, and now
we got a tag in.
Mr. Gold on the ball.
Wait a minute, I think it was just a high five.
Yeah, this is a high five.
Oh, come on, get the little prick in the damn ring. I was going to ask.
Little Mike is working on that arm evasion.
Little Mike is working on get your ass in the ring now, you jackass.
Titan kicks the face of Little Mike, playing innocent as usual.
I can't stand that son of a bitch.
Flair's tagged in.
And here he comes.
Ooh, he's lighting him up. He's lighting him up.
Lightning up the chest of the fat Asian with those vicious nature boy-like chops.
Absolutely, Ross. Electrifying. It's like a skillet getting hit across your chest.
Indeed, Cross, indeed.
And he's stomping on Asian over and over.
The Nate is stomping away. Come on, Titan, get your ass in there. I want to see you get chopped like a motherfucker.
Flair's telling Titan, get tagged in, but wait a minute.
And now Asian, fight back. Vicious, right, west, to the Nature Boy.
Irish whip right there in the clothesline.
Ooh, a big clothesline by. And now he gets his ass in.
Ooh, he got it.
Woo! Chop his ass.
He's lighting him up here, folks, in the corner. Flair was able to dodge. Titan.
Ooh, there's a big one. And now Mike is getting it on the fray. Trying to pull the hair or whatever.
And Gage Flair was strutting away.
Indeed.
Irish whip.
Look out.
Oh,
a clothesline by the Nature Boy.
Looks like Titan jumped into that.
Come to tag him in. He ain't. Asian said no.
There you go, Asian.
And Flair gets on him. Flair gets on him.
Chopping away at the sucker playing best.
Two, three.
He blocks it. He got the arm of the Nature Boy and threw him into that corner.
Titan kicking and punching, kicking and punching.
We got a bulldog.
What a bulldog delivered there by Titan.
One, two, and all the Nate kicked out. Wait, did we get a tag? No, we didn't, but we got a tag there.
I knew this match was
going to happen. Wait, we did get a tag. Mike is in the ring.
Mike is now in the ring.
Oh, big kick. Big boot by Mike.
What a kick delivered by Mike.
That's probably a size 12 foot going into your facial features.
I knew this match was going to be fast paced and a lot of action, but now we've got Little Mike once again on Asian.
Indeed, a camel clutch, it would seem, applied onto the party animal himself.
All right, I think he had to break it up.
Broke the hold. Asian, yes.
Asian got the ropes there. And
now Asian ground and pound offense onto Little Mike.
What's he going for?
Oh, big splash.
A big splash.
One, two.
One of those big executed splashes of Asian.
Only got a two there, but the fat Asian after that big splash.
Now he's pounding away.
Pounding away. Right. Look out.
Little Mike got on him. Now he's
ground and pound. Now Mike is grinding and pounding away.
Yeah, absolutely there. And now we've got Little Mike back up. He's working on the leg of Asian.
He's got him in a leg bar of some sort or an E bar.
And you can see Little Mike's looking back at Gage Flair, probably showing him what is going to happen to him.
Indeed.
Or some sort of way.
Some sort of message being sent by Little Mike.
And it looks like Little Mike let go of that hole.
Wow, the Nature's clapping for his teammate here. Wow.
Of course, he doesn't want to lose here tonight.
I don't blame him. I don't blame the Nature one bit.
But once again, Little Mike is playing smart.
He's playing smart, but I would keep him away from that corner right there because he could tag Titan any minute.
Come on, let's get you back in the air.
And Titan gets off the apron. Come on, you little bastard. Get him a damn match.
I think he's telling him to get in there.
Oh, come on. What are you getting out of the fucking jackass? He won't get it. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah. Asian pounding away on Little Mike.
This is one hell of a match. One hell of a match. But poor Asian, his partner,
he's a dick. That's what it's
trying to do.
Look out.
He was able to dodge that baseball slide.
Baseball slide is nobody home for the baseball slide.
And he has the... Let's go. Wow. Grab on him.
Come on. And I think Asian just shit himself.
I think that's exactly what just happened with that Boston crab walked in.
Oh my God. Close your legs.
Oh, wait a minute. And the match is still rolling.
The match is still rolling after that Asian-like fart. Whatever. I don't know what he ate for before he came, but it must stunk. But anyway, back to calling the action, folks. Little Mike. Oh, a slap of some sort to Little Mike, my fat Asian.
Come on. And looks like Titan is in.
Back in.
Was there a tag by, I guess.
Clothesline by Titan right there to Mike and an elbow.
There was a tag.
There was a tag and Titan's in. Titan's going up.
Uh-oh, Titan is climbing to the top. What's going to happen? Elbow, frog splash, whatever. And here he goes.
It's like a frog splash.
Geronimo.
What a frog splash.
Oh, what?
Flair's got a hold of him. Flair's got a hold.
Oh! Flair gets drilled. He gets nailed.
Oh, what a knee right there. It's a Little Mike.
What a knee.
Oh, what a two, oh!
So much action, so much action.
Oh, super kick right to the face.
Super kick right to the face.
One, two, oh!
Little Mike was able to kick out. Just barely able to kick out.
Good Lord. Back and forth action.
Oh, he catches his leg. Oh, what's he doing? What's he doing?
Wait a minute. Oh, my God, no. We're going to see a tombstone. We're going to see a tombstone pile driver.
Holy shit. Titan almost had his neck broke right there.
They should, but come on, ban that. That's illegal.
Flair's tagged in.
Where is he in? I think Titan might know where he is right
now. Titan tagged in Asian.
Good call there.
Well, he poked him in the eyes there.
Wait and what's this? Suplex.
Oh, my God, a suplex.
A snap suplex delivered by Flair.
One, two.
It was only a two. Count delivered there by Flair after that vicious snap suplex.
I still can't get over that tombstone.
Wait a minute. What's Flair setting up? Spear!
Holy shit!
Spear! By the nage!
Holy crap!
Flair was able to get in that spear executed.
Good grief! What a spear!
And now he's stomping away on Asian and picking him up.
He's lifting Asian. I would have left him down, Flair. I would have left him down. Wait a minute.
Oh, we got an Irish whip.
Oh,
he's
dodging.
He dodges.
Back. Oh, clothesline.
Clothesline by Asian.
Oh, and another one.
Asian is dropping Flair again.
Oh, punch. Right hands by Asian. To the nage.
Down goes Flair to those right hands of Asian.
One, two.
No.
You
know
what time it is. Get him in the corner.
And now Asian talking to his tag team partner.
Come on, let's bring it up.
What's he going to do right here? What's he doing? He's picking up Flair.
He's picking up the nage. Into the corner.
What are they setting up? What are they setting up?
Wait a minute. Poetry in motion.
Oh!
Little teamwork there. That's a first.
Wait a minute. Flair's groggy. Flair's groggy.
He's groggy.
He goes down. Flop. Signature flare flop and Titan.
Pinball. Count it. One. No. Mike breaks up that pin. Come on.
He breaks up the pin right there.
Man, this match is one hell of a roller coaster.
It's a slobber knocker there, Cross.
What's he
Titan's
got
Flair now. Wait a minute.
Oh, what a clothesline.
Wait a minute.
He caught him.
He caught him. And now Flair. Flair, Irish whips.
Woo! Look out.
And a Hurricanrana.
Oh!
Hurricanrana by Titan.
What a beautifully executed Hurricanrana delivered by Titan.
What's he doing right here? What's he doing right here?
Wait a minute. What's going to happen now?
What's he doing? What's he doing? We got a running knee.
Whoa! Knee strike by Titan.
A running knee delivered by Titan. Flair's hurting. Not fair to Flair.
Not fair to Flair indeed there, Cross. What a vicious knee to the face.
Now he's stomping on him and picking him. He's trying to go for the pin. One, two. And he kills
him.
Rolled him up.
Wait, he wants that tag. Can he get it? He got the tag.
And Mike is in the ring.
And Asian's back in too.
Business is about to pick up, folks.
What a hot tag right there. Oh, what a kick by Little Mike.
Mike is
one, two.
Oh, kick out.
Only a two there, folks.
Only a two count there, ladies and gentlemen.
Flair needs to play smart. Rest up, Flair. Rest up.
Not fair to Flair and I'll say it again.
And we got, wait a minute.
You got some in a headlock or something. Some sort of.
What in the world? I don't know what to call that, folks.
But they're now they're getting back to their feet right here. Oh!
Both men are getting back up to the feet. And looks like little Mike is laying in on Asian.
What in the world?
Wait, who's that? Who's
wait a minute! Oh, wait a minute! Yeah. It's the general manager!
Oh, he's taking out Titan! Holy crap!
Definitely business about to pick up. Josh Allen is beating the shit out of Potomac Titan.
Joshua Allen has mayhem to take out Titan, and now he takes out Titan.
Oh, wait a minute. Come on. You can throw it up again.
Now Titan got a hold of him.
Oh, no. Look out. What's going to happen now?
What's he going to do?
Wait a minute. Oh!
Ran into the entranceway.
Face first in the entranceway.
That'll mess up the Hollywood looks of Titan.
Absolutely.
And he's carrying him backstage.
Both men are going to the backstage area.
Oh, God. What's going to happen back there? But meanwhile, Asian is left alone. Asian has got no partner.
Oh, my God.
Superman!
Mind blown right to the face.
Wait a minute. Both men arguing. Both men arguing.
They're arguing. What are they doing?
Flair eye gouges. He pokes him in the eye. Low blow.
What the hell? Typical dirtiest player of the game. Tactic.
And he's locking him up.
He is the legal man. He's the legal man. And he's got the figure four locked in. He's got the figure four locked in.
He's got it locked in. He's got
it tapping.
He's tapping. Oh,
Mike and Flair win this tag team matchup.
Oh, Flair became the legal man after he eye gouged little Mike.
Why the hell would he eye gouge and low blow Mike? What the hell?
You seen the confrontation they had earlier in the night?
Yeah, I seen it. I'm not dumb.
I can't wait for this matchup.
Once again, the dirtiest player in the game.
Oh, Mike with a big boot.
Oh, it's like an enziguri right there.
Or an enziguri, whatever the hell he did.
Flair's down. He's down, but he is the winner of this match.
Flair just got drilled by little Mike. And this is far from over, ladies and gentlemen. I can guarantee you that. Far from over.
Let's see what little Mike has to say.
You'll be the one to say, I quit.
Over my dead body. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a submission match at Summer Bash!
We're both titles on the line! Who's going to walk out of the winner of that? We will see you next week! Thank you for watching episode 81!
Good night, everybody, and buy my fucking sauce!
And God bless!
Goodbye and good night!
This barbecue sauce is good!